Good morning, my friends. Yesterday I got 2 quads. Like you see, Polaris Hockey. I don't know how to say hockey, but it's Polaris 2006. Working, driving. Working and driving. Issue with this one, or how to say problems with this one. All front. All front is big problem. Somebody will drive this quad, but they don't give a fuck about nothing. You see? He's just dead. Oh, expensive stuff. Another thing, tires is new. I paid 2,800. 2,800 euro for this quad. I don't know if I overpaid, but guy don't wanna sell me cheaper. He say, if you don't want, you don't buy. Find another one. But here in Ireland, I cannot find anything what I want. That's why I took hockey, because I have original winch. This I can fix. Now, the surprise me, I have ventilator, but no radiator. This is very surprise. This one here is fine. But now, I don't understand about 4x4 quads anything. And I can't spin wheels. This quad don't spinning wheels. I don't know why. Or my quad is sleeping, engine sleeping, and needs something wake up this quad. People who watch my videos and who understand, maybe they will can tell me what's wrong with that. Like you see, new tires, new shocks. So that's why I understand guy who don't wanna make for me cheaper. He put new tires, new shocks. It's expensive stuff. Starting driving, no problem. Yeah, what I saw yesterday, this I need fix gear shift here. It's falling down. So, you see, he put many cable ties, but this shift is not holding too much. Okay, so this is sensor for engage, to see to show for me gears. Oh my cat. So, okay, this driving, no problem. Now, Suzuki Godzilla, the most maybe stupid quad ever. I don't know, I don't understand, but it's no spark. So this one I paid 2,800 euro, and this one 8,600 euro. If I connect my battery, I have power, computer works, everything works here, except not turning the engine, and maybe starter gone, and the guy say is no spark. The problem is with this, I don't know. So my plan is today. I bought this quad because I like this alloy wheels, and I thought will fit in my, if I buy in the future this Yamaha, this wheels will fit, but no. This front wheel will fit on my hockey, no problem. But the rear wheel is fucking strange because it's 100. Same like my Skoda, for my Renault Clio. So this wheels, this alloy, super light wheels, I can fit on this quad, on red quad, this alloys will go. I don't need any spacers, I hope. I think so, maybe, yeah, we'll see, it's strange. But now, how it looks, this quad, it's very dirty quad. Design is amazing. It looks bigger. It looks bigger than my Polaris. Everything is very dirty, you see. What I like, he has two ventilators and radiator. And this one, 300. Oh, this is ignition coil. Okay, that's very good. So my plan is take off all plastics. And my plan is check if this dry shaft will fit on my Polaris. I don't think so it will fit, but nothing happened if I try. So I save a lot of money if this will fit on my Polaris, because if I buy from eBay, it's 300 euro cost this, two of them. I can't understand why on the back cost 120 euro set, and on here on the front is 300 euro. And this is what I need, no bushings, you see? So I'm happy with that. I need to fix that, and we'll see how it's going with this one. Now, about video time, I don't care, like I said before. My English is bad, but my English is like my English. So this 4x4, I don't understand what it means, electric shifter. I can't understand. I know it's automatic. All these things is working. Energy coming. I have key. I have kill switch. Here is very brakes are good. I need just everything clean. It has diff lock and he has whatever. It looks cool. I like this. It's rusty, but this is what I want. This is what I'm looking for. Yesterday at night it looks more difficult everything, but now it looks very simple. Anyway, it looks so. This one video about these two quads, how it looks now, okay? They look similar. For Polaris need more power, for this need fix everything. So I say, I may repeat again, take off all plastics, wash everything, and we'll see what I can do with this one. Lights working, ignition works, everything, okay, whatever. I repeat again. So, time to work. Time to work. So now is 8 minutes. I need to lift this, and I need to lift my quad and see if I'm driving on two wheels or always four wheels, or everything is fine. I cannot understand. So I need to lift this and see. So yeah, is nothing changed? Always 4x4. Always 4x4. But now I see in this working good, so this is, I'm happy for that. I thought it will be broken something here in differential from inside the differential, but this not working. I gonna check fuse, and I need to check the sensor. I think this is sensor. I think there is some sensor because cable's coming there. So first my plan is work with this guy. And after, if I found how to off 4x4, I'm be happy. And then I wanna work with my Suzuki. So for the moment, that's it. Like, I gonna work and will back soon. I don't wanna make long very video, so I try to do the best what I can. Check all fuses. I don't know, I never work like I say with 4x4, so okay, that's it, I gonna work. So if I disconnect this cable from this cable, if I disconnect, if I on neutral, I disconnect cable, so my front wheels not driving anymore, okay? And then again, if I connect, he start driving, but then again don't wanna off. So maybe, I hope it's just problem here. And if not, for the moment I will drive without cable like this, just leave cable like this. And but now I wanna open and see inside what is there, and then we'll see. Looks like something is missing from this one, because look how it looks here. I have, so my basically is touching top but not bottom, so maybe I can on but not off. I don't know. So basically it's four cables coming to this sensor here, to this button, switch on, switch off. I need to find out how to make this working. I need to go find parts from somewhere and try. Because now if I start, I'm gonna try something. What is most annoying about people, they fucking do something, they don't know what they fucking do. So now is okay, only rear wheels drive, okay? That's it. Front no. But if now, if I touch this without off the gear, Okay, so now I touch and front wheels drive, okay? But if I touch here, I do nothing, it's not working. So what I need to do, press brakes to stop my rear axle, put in neutral, touch bottom one, and now should work. Still engage, wait. Stop. Now should work maybe. Now it sometimes works, sometimes not. But it's working anyway. So that means part is missing. So this is what I need to do. I need to fix the fucking this switch. That's it. Stupid people, I hate them. It's so annoying. Sorry for these things, people, but it's really annoying. Okay, I'm gonna work and I will back if I fix everything. What more I don't like, because there is broken now, my tire touching, you know, is a lot. Like, I don't know, it's very strange. I can remove. So, because basically for me, no need this one. Awesome. But so like a drift tires, drift quad now, because it's very, very big. Oh, the fucking, okay, I'm gonna work, we'll see. I hope from Suzuki will fit that, but I not expect, but maybe, maybe front shaft will fit in this one, because I wanna good fix this one first. Okay, I'm gonna somehow try to fix that. That's it, Polaris is done, I can drive. Soon in the future, I will order parts in the front. I put for rear wheel from the Suzuki front, and I put on the back, but still not spinning wheels, you can't drift. So maybe I need to change tires, tires non-grip. So another thing, now I'm taking out all parts for this one, and we'll see if I can just make a run today. It looks bigger, much bigger than Polaris, so I don't know what's wrong. I don't know. We'll see. The guy says no ignition, but it's so rusty, look, even fucking hole in the muffler. So it's strange. Suzuki is not great quads. Polaris is not great quads. I like Yamaha, it's the best. That's it.